turn off the white noise.
Tell the court what you know about Rule 1.18,
May I review 1.18?
Have you reviewed it before these proceedings?
May I read it? Can you
yes,
give it to me?
And if I may approach him with my motion, Your Honor, it's cited in there.
How about you give him the book?
I
like the book better than
your
exhibit, because your exhibit is for the ABA, and the book is for Nevada.
The court has
he has 18 books. If you want to do, I don't have my book.
There is a difference between Ms. Vaccarino. This is the reason I made a stink about it earlier.
If you want me to bring the book to court, I'll
there is not. There is a difference between the model rules of conduct adopted by the American Bar Association and Nevada's rules on professional responsibility. They are not identical rules, counsel.
Let me ask you, Mr. Dickerson, are you governed by the Nevada rules of professional conduct?
Yes
or no?
Yes.
Do you feel that you also are governed by the American Bar Association rules of their comments and their conduct? Do you find those as guidelines for yourself? Yes or no?
Do I find them as guidelines?
Yeah, guidelines on how to make sure that you are doing your utmost for your professional responsibility for your clients.
Are we doing best practices again?
No, that you're making sure that you are following the rules.
Which rules, counsel?
The rules of professional conduct. Yep. Which is more important to you, the American Bar Association rules or the rules of professional conduct?
The rules of professional conduct
okay.
I am bound by.
Okay. Then if I may approach with you 1.18.
Objection.
Your exhibit is not 1.18, number one.
That doesn't have to be. He wants to look at the rule. I'm trying to help him.
But that's not the rule. That's the problem I keep raising, counsel.
Your Honor, it is. Nevada Rule of Professional Conduct 1.18 is cited in my brief at page 2.
There's a book right here. Can I use this book?
Your Honor,
I cited the ABA comments because Bar Counsel Mr. Hoagie was supposed to come in and he directed us to those. So I wanted him to comment on them, but he's in a surgical proceeding and he would have been much more help, I think, today. However,
I thought Mr. Patino was quite helpful.
Yes, but he kind of flip-flopped a little on that. He said probably
objection,
on stuff, didn't know about the mediation rule. Hey, I'm just saying it like it is.
Your Honor, that's a speaking objection.
Actually, I will state that in the motion, you actually cited Nevada's rule, but in the exhibit that you have, you cited the ABA.
Well, you're not to look at them until they're admitted. Because I was expecting Hoagie to come to court, and he directed us to there on Friday. I'm also going to ask that I be allowed to testify because you ordered us to try and work this out with Bar Counsel. And those are the information.
Good, then who's going to come in to represent your client for you?
Supreme Court rule allows me to be attorney and advocate, especially if it's an underlying issue, like the side issue. I can cite that rule to you as well. But for today's purposes, I'm trying to get to the bottom of what Mr. It's not me that's being challenged
okay.
on this rule.
If you want him to look at your motion.
I just want him to tell me what he thinks of the rule. You want him to look at it? He asked to look at it?
If I can simplify, I brought a copy of rule, a very clean copy.
Is this the rule from
1.18 from the Nevada Bar? I'd be happy to provide it to him.
That's the one
copied
you have him look at it, counsel. But your exhibit was a commentary from the American Bar Association, which is not our rules. I'm trying to be very...
It's very close. Right now. I wish we'll probably address
it. No, actually not. There's quite a huge difference.
May I hand it to the witness, Your Honor?
Yes, you may.
I trust him that it's the content from the book. I don't have to take a look at it.
Okay.
He wants to read the rule, so you want me to let him do that, right? If Caroline believed she was a prospective client, her perception, when she talked to you on July 2nd, do you agree this rule requires that you provide her with notice of subsequent representation?
No, I believe if she were
tell me this then. It's you've made the decision yourself, not the bar, not the judge, that she wasn't a prospective client, or Joe did as of October 17 in this case, correct?
Objection, argumentative.
Sustained.
Who made the decision that she was not a prospective client and when?
I don't think that decision was made, but I think if we take a look at the rule, particularly at subparagraph E, provides a person who communicates information to a lawyer without any reasonable expectation that the lawyer is willing to discuss the possibility of forming a client-lawyer relationship or for the purpose which do not include a good faith intention to retain the lawyer in the subject matter of the consultation is not a prospective client within the meaning of the rule.
Perfect. Now we agree that Caroline has to have the reasonable expectation that you're willing to discuss the possibility of an attorney-client relationship, according to that rule, correct?
I don't know if
you just read it.
I don't understand your question, Ms. Pacquiao.
Then I'll withdraw it. I'm going to show you this. If I may, Your Honor.
Yeah, do you want to get permission to approach next time?
If I may approach, Your Honor, the witness, or just tell him where to go on page, the same where everybody else was going. Page 4 of Exhibit 4, you have also discussed of your retainer agreement.
Page 4, Exhibit 4, okay. Where do you want me to?
The third full paragraph.
The one that says you also have discussed?
With me, the, quote, possibility that you may need me to draft paperwork to finalize any settlement you reach and to finalize your divorce with entry of a decree of divorce. Wasn't that statement right there under Subsection 8 that you just read, the discussion of the possibility for you to prepare a decree for these two parties?
Objection.
Yes or no?
Yeah. Yeah, it was.
What?
What's the objection?
The document speaks for itself. It's cumulative.
Your objection, Your Honor.
What?
That's not a proper
objection. I'm overruling the objection.
Yeah, I talked to them about if they want to meet to prepare the documents that needed to be filed with the court. For the purpose of finalizing any settlement they reach through mediation.
Through a decree of divorce, correct?
Objection, she interrupted the witness again.
Through a decree of divorce, correct? Not a memorandum of understanding, correct? Correct me if I'm wrong, that you offered to do a decree of divorce, not a memorandum of understanding for mediation.
I offered to prepare every document that they needed in order to finalize their divorce, including the decree.
Objection, she keeps interrupting the witness.
No, he was finished.
And from Caroline, you have no idea of what was in Caroline's head when she spoke to you, what her perception was of how you were acting on July 2nd unless you ask her, correct?
Ms. Vaccarino?
Wait, can you answer my question? Do you have any idea? If it's yes, it's yes, and then we'll follow up. Of what Caroline thought you were acting as when she spoke to you on July 2nd, yes or no?
When she spoke with all three of us on the phone?
No, I'm asking when you spoke to her at all. Whether
I,
you.
I didn't speak to her alone. I never spoke to her.
Does it matter if you spoke three-way? Or just with her alone, if you have the possibility of being her attorney to prepare her a decree, does it really matter if you're speaking with a three-way or just a two-way? Because
well,
confidentiality is already waived, correct?
Objection, well, argumentative.
How could...
Sustained.
Tell me, isn't it true when you represent two people for a joint petition that they waive their right to confidentiality? Yes or no? Tell the court.
Ms. Vaccarino, I would never, ever represent...
Your Honor, I'll move to strike. It's yes or no.
Well, actually, it's not a yes or no if you can't answer it yes or no.
Can you answer that? Have you ever prepared a joint petition for two parties?
Objection.
As a lawyer, no. I have never done that.
Have you ever offered to prepare a joint petition for two parties? Yes or no?
As a mediator, I have.
So you can be a mediator that turns into an attorney at what point when you prepare the joint petition? When do you put the attorney hat on? Tell the court.
Objection. It assumes facts and law, not evidence.
I'm always...
Wait. Assumes facts and not an evidence?
Yeah.
Your Honor, I think it's an appropriate question. When he thought he would have switched hats.
It's argumentative.
Argumentative.
I think it is argumentative. I'm sustaining the objection.
Is
rephrase.
Okay. Is it? Well, you have a law license, correct?
I do.
Do you know any mediators in town that have just... qualifications for mediating, but not a law license? Yes or no?
sure there are. I
have you before this date.
Objection.
Okay, I'm sorry, I did cut you off. You sure there are?
I don't know.
I'm sure there are. I mean, there's mediators that do. I mean, we have mediators here that are part of Family Mediation Service that
okay.
are not attorneys.
So, you didn't refer them to an alternate mediator. You said you were going to mediate and prepare the documents if a settlement was reached, correct?
I told them I would be more than happy to serve as their mediator.
And your legal and factual position is that you've never crossed the line of receiving information and providing any advice to prepare a joint petition. Is that your testimony today, Mr. Dickerson?
Can you repeat that, please?
Is it your test?
Let her repeat the question before
Sorry.
You object. Really. I'm getting really, really tired of this three-ring circus where everybody interrupts everybody, including the judge. Could you all just decide you're going to be adults in my court? And just think before you speak. Now, ask your question again, Ms. Vaccarino, and I expect there will be no more interruptions because I don't think Mr. Caraccioni wants to pay any more money to the Legal Aid Center unless he does so with an open heart.
Without legal knowledge, do you believe there could be some confusion on the litigant's part when you've offered to prepare legal documents and be a mediator at once? Yes or no?
Objection calls for speculation.
Sustained.
In your experience, okay, that's sustained, that's...
It's sustained.
Okay. Tell the court, didn't Caroline and Shane both tell you it was very important that they save money and not make appearances in court? Get their divorce done? Yes or no? Do you recall that?
Well, I recall them discussing that they wanted to try to avoid getting involved in litigation, and that was the purpose of their mediation.
And Caroline said she didn't want to hire two attorneys, she just wanted to be able to hire one attorney, which may be you if you offered to prepare the joint petition, correct?
No, that's not correct.
You don't recall her asking you if you could be her attorney and Shane's attorney at the same time? You never recall that question?
I do recall.
Okay, who asked you it?
But she didn't ask the question.
Oh.
I recall that she never asked that question,
Great.
Never
so
discussed it.
As a thorough attorney, understanding these rules of professional conduct, you brought up the issue of dual representation in a joint petition. Did you not, Mr. Dickerson?
No,
no?
No?
You never brought it up to either of these parties, that there could be a conflict in dual representation after. Is that your testimony?
I explained to both of them, as a mediator, I am not there to give legal advice. I'm there to facilitate a settlement.
And even in the course of pre-mediation or in the throes of mediation, isn't there times when you're still not allowed to represent either party you mediated for? Yes or no?
Could you please repeat that?
Even in pre-mediation discussions on the phone and or just pure mediation sessions where you don't even mention a joint petition, isn't there still limitations on whether or not you're able to represent either of the parties that you assisted in mediation?
Objection.
Compound. Yeah, your understanding of the law?
Objection compound assumes facts not in evidence.
Sustained.
Rephrase. Are you allowed to...
Rephrase.
I am. Are you allowed, if you're just purely a mediator, no dispute at all. Two separate attorneys, they send him to Bob Dickerson as an attorney mediator. Under what conditions are you allowed, if any, to represent either of those parties later?
If those two parties were involved in a dispute that was not substantially similar or the same of the issue that I was mediating.
Would you agree that when Caroline gave you all this information in Exhibit 5 and 6, it was regarding timeshare, setting child support, setting alimony, and dividing assets and debts?
No.
Yes?
Objection mischaracterizes
no?
the exhibits.
Okay, then are you going to sustain?
I'm going to sustain it.
Okay, so go ahead and look at number 6.
Exhibit 6.
Did this state every single thing that each of the parties said to you and you said to them on July 2nd? Yes or no?
The first part.
I'm asking you if this document is a full 100% transcript of what was discussed between you and the parties.
No.
Okay. And also, you told them you need documents from them?
Okay. So you're talking about... I can explain this, too, if you really want to know about it.
And you received all of this information about... Who told you that... my client, Caroline, allegedly made $140,000 per year.
Neither of them told me that.
Well, how'd you put that in there?
I didn't put that in there.
Who put that in there?
That would be the, at intake, when a person calls the office and asks to have us either represent or do mediation or what have you, we do a conflicts check. So when Mr. Jensen would have called in, he would have called in initially. He would have told, I'm assuming he would
Wait
have told.
Wait a minute, what exhibit are we on, 7?
Six.
We're on exhibit 6, and we're
six.
At the bottom paragraph,
he's
and you're saying that
exhibit.
You
Objection.
Didn't, I think he's trying to explain, Your Honor, that the bottom of this thing wasn't actually created on July 2nd, if I'm following your testimony.
No, Objection.
It wasn't created on July 2nd.
Are you testifying, counsel? I'm getting here really lost here.
Are you confused?
Because you said exhibit 7, so I looked at exhibit 7.
Move to strike. I said exhibit 7.
And then I realized it wasn't admitted, so I stopped looking at it, and I went, why are we talking about exhibit 7?
We were talking about 6.
Okay.
And his answer is non-responsive. But
well, that's my decision.
In this document, there's information that you received about the parties' facts in their divorce, correct?
If you would like me to explain to you, I'd be more than happy to explain this to you.
And I'm sure that your partner will cross-examine you as to that. But my question is to you, this is information that you gained knowledge about both parties' goals in the divorce, and it's in this memo, correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. I have nothing further, Your Honor.
Anybody want to take a 5-minute break? I sure would.
Sure. Yes, sir.
Mr. Dickerson, you're not going to make your other appointment.
I've got a conference call before, so I've got to put that back.